CU-2022-02.
Okay, Madam Chairman, this is also a conditional use request, which is by Bemiss Development Partners for a self-storage mini warehouse facility in CC zoning. The zoning map on the screen just depicts the subject property, which is 4036 Bemiss Road. You may recall this being a very identical request from back last summer, where it was to convert the existing former grocery store, which we remember as Winn Dixie for many years, which has also been sitting empty for several years, but to convert that building into a climate-controlled self-storage facility. No proposed changes to the building, only proposed changes to the site would be for outdoor storage and the side and rear parking areas, which are the truck loading areas. Front parking lot would remain a parking lot for now. The other buildings of the shopping center, which is that building to the south, would continue on as its retail building under CC zone. A lot of discussion about this last year. Staff's view, thinking long term, is the need of the parking lot was for the shopping center, mainly the grocery store. The parking demand goes significantly downward with converting this large building. Therefore, the parking is not needed. Staff believes it's only a matter of time before we would see out parcels created out of that parking lot. And basically keeping the shopping center theme of the property, it's just the anchor would be a large storage building rather than a grocery store. Site plan is in your packet. This is mostly the same materials from back in the summer. The one caveat here we talked about at the work session is you know that when a request such as this is denied, there's a 12-month waiting period before another request, whether it be the same one or even a different one, can be submitted for the same property. That rule in the city's development code has a clause at the end that allows someone to petition the city council for a shorter period of time, as long as that period of time is not less than 6 months. And in this case, that is what the applicant did. Back in January, which was on month number 7, they petitioned the city council to essentially resubmit the same request before waiting the full 12 months. City council approved that. The request was submitted and it is brought before this evening. So that's why it seems like a little bit early, and that is the reason for it. So again, in your packet, a lot of familiar looking materials from last summer, including the site plan, subject property, the grocery store building, which is projected to remain essentially unchanged except for the signage. The building to the south is seen from the parking lot, closer view of that building. This is from last year. And then the truck loading and maneuverability area around the sides and the rear. Remember, this was a point of discussion last summer in terms of how this is to be buffered and screened. Adjacent properties, this is the bank to the north, and then some of the other commercial development across the street on the other side of Bemiss Road. Applicant's proposed view is, this is their rendition of the same buildings, same tenants, except different signage on the front of the former grocery store building. Zoom up view would be this. And then aerial view, looking at the proposal for the outdoor storage, is to screen this with a opaque chain of fence, with gated, and then additional landscaping pushed to the front. So a gate on the south side, and then an emergency gate on the north side. They're trying to focus their primary access for that area on the south side of the building. In other words, away from the bank. Some of the landscaping with the existing trees over there. So with that, just like last year, staff is recommending approval of the conditional use with a series of conditions. I amended one of the conditions from staff's list last year to reflect what the Planning Commission recommended last year. That would be condition number 2. And to refresh your memory, the vote of the Planning Commission last summer was 9-1 to recommend approval of these conditions. And for the sake of those in attendance today, let me run through the conditions. Number 1, approval shall be granted for a self-storage mini warehouse business in the existing main building only, and with accessory outdoor storage in the side and rear yard areas behind the front wall of this existing main building only. Number two, the outdoor storage area shall be enclosed on the sides and rear by a minimum 8 foot tall privacy fence. The fence portions facing the south and west shall be permanently opaque and solid. The fence portions facing the north and east shall be either be permanently opaque and solid, or instead have an added mesh screen for temporary opacity to allow time for vegetation to grow and fill in. Some of the discussion last summer was this area to behind it to the east is future residential. It has not materialized yet, but is also a little bit of a distance behind. But it was 125 lot single family neighborhood being proposed back there. A landscape strip between the existing pavement edge and the property line shall be planted and maintained along the sides and rear of the outdoor storage area. The landscaping that consists of a minimum 6 small trees and 2 canopy trees for 100 linear feet, as approved by the city arborist. All trees shall be evergreen. Number 3, outdoor storage items shall be limited only to motor vehicles and customary recreational vehicles, such as boats and campers and their associated trailers. All outdoor items shall be operative and in good working condition and neatly parked at all times. There shall be no heavy trucks or equipment or other materials allowed. In other words, not a salvage. Number 4, conditional use approval shall expire after 3 years from the date of approval if the proposed use has not received a CO from the city by that date. And again, most of their work would be the extensive renovations on the interior of the large building. The applicants here, if you have any questions for them, otherwise I'd be glad to answer your questions for them.
Thanks, Matt.
I'm just curious, what was the driver last time for tonight?
If you may recall, we had a, I think, a competitor business speak in opposition at your meeting.
Mm-hmm.
We had a different competitor speak at the city council meeting. I know there was a lot of background concerning city council, really a lament that this is not the grocery store moving forward. And so I think the vote was 4-3 at the city council meeting. So the recommendation 9-1 for approval from this group, the city council denied it 4-3.
So if we look in the denial, I'm sorry, my lips didn't work properly. It was already a super Walmart grocery store within a block store against us as a grocery store. So really that's not a driver in this at all, grocery store.
It may have been a driver for Winn Dixie to leave. Don't know. There's other chains
that's
out there.
True, but I mean this is a store thing, so interesting.
The applicant I know has a story to tell about their marketing efforts. So there may be some information there for us.
I have a quick question. So the fence is going to run along the edge of the curb, and then the buffer will be whatever they can fit in between the property line and the curb.
Right. With new development and with residential zoning abutting part of this, there's a buffer yard required. In some places, the property line is up close to the curb. In some places around there, it's 8 to 15 feet away. So it's not, there's no way to have a nice, neat, parallel buffer yard with the curbing without completely redoing the curbing. So we tried to word the conditions so that we put a fence up close, put some opacity to it, even if it's a temporary measure, and then put vegetation on the outside of the fence that will eventually grow in. And it may be by that time the neighborhood might start construction. That being said, we've had that subdivision plan for more than 7 years now, and it hasn't started yet. So it's hard to predict when the houses will get built, and maybe by then this is probably coming along sooner. Vegetation hopefully will be thicker by then.
Have more on some. All right then. Is there anyone here tonight who wishes to speak on behalf of this, if you'll come forward?
Commission. My name is Craig Taylor. I live at 4 Fox Hollow Circle in the city of Valdosta. I purchased this property in December of this year after watching what I considered to be a mistake at the city council level last year. I thought this was a very good project. I felt like there was some misjudgment because the property owners and developers who were coming into town were not local people and didn't have the same level of access maybe that some of us local people might have. I purchased it and am partnering with that initial group because I think that the project they have in mind is a very good way to restore what is an embarrassing eyesore on Bemiss on the way to the base into something that's good for the tax base and is a very necessary thing in the community. They have commissioned a study from the subject matter experts on storage, and it may seem like we have a lot of storage at our lot side. I know I personally felt that way when I first looked at it. We do not have a lot of climate controlled storage. We are actually on the bottom of the list as far as that goes. So I thought this was a really good repurpose. I did speak to friends on city council and heard very much a concern that there was not affordable grocery options on that side of town. In my marketing efforts in the past 6 months, I've been looking at this project since about 6 months ago, we have been turned down by 34 grocery stores. I didn't know there were that many grocery store brands out there, but if they exist, they have turned us down for grocery stores. And for reasons that you very much have mentioned already, that area is well satisfied and well served by a Walmart grocery that exists there now. So with that being considered, then what other uses might be used? And we have looked at quite a few things, but it looks to me like self-storage is the way to go for this. And it fits very well with the traffic pattern. It will decrease traffic, as the staff has said to you. And these conditions, I think, are very reasonable conditions. And if I lived in that area, I'd want to see those as well. So that's why we request this. And we did go before the city council and say, can we come back early? Because we've done a lot of work on this, and we're not moving the ball on anything else. And in conversation with each of those folks, not predicting how they might vote in the future, but in conversation, it seemed like a reasonable time period that you have waited. And so we're ready to move forward with that. I don't know that you guys care, but it's something that I always care about. Everything that we're going to do here is going to be as locally sourced as we can, including the financing, including the contract labor, and that sort of thing as well, because we're local people, and that's how we like to be treated, and not that to be treated in our projects as well. Happy to answer any questions.
Any questions? Thank you, Charlie. All right, is there anyone else tonight who would like to speak on behalf of this request? All right, is there anyone tonight wishing to speak against this request, if you'll come forward? Anyone wishing to speak against? All right, commissioners, if not, if there's any discussion or questions for staff, and if not, I'll call for the motion.
Madam Chairman.
Mr. Wiles, you're busy tonight.
Regarding conditional use request CU-2022-02 for conditional use of the self-storage meat warehouse facility in the CC zoning district. As staff explained completely the history and the reason where we are today, and this does appear to be a good use for this property. I'd like to recommend we recommend approval with the staff's four conditions.
All right, we have a recommendation for approval with conditions, and we do have it seconded by Commissioner Bailey. Any discussion?
Okay, I'd just like to say what Trey said about being slack and our climate control usage in our area is very much spot on. I mean, it is a tremendous need.
I agree. And the thought of not approving something because you want something else to go in there is not good business. So I applaud you, Trey, for moving forward on this project and taking the initiative to ask that it be heard early. All right, so we have a motion to approve and a second. All those in favor of the motion to approve, please raise your right hand. All those against? All right, and that will carry. Thank you. Good luck to y'all. All right, moving forward, variance request 2022-01.
Madam Chairman, this is a repetitive request.